As we've reported, negotiators from around the world are meeting in Glasgow for a second week, all part of the UN summit aimed at getting new commitments and actions to reduce greenhouse gas emissions. Pressure has been building on the streets this weekend, and today there was a call for meaningful change beyond the rhetoric of these gatherings. William Brangham is there for us all week, and he joins me now. So hello, William. We know you just arrived in Glasgow yesterday. Tell us, in the time you've been there, what are you seeing? What are you hearing?
Well, Judy, as you mentioned, we landed here and there were enormous protests over the weekend. They thought almost 100,000 people on the streets on Saturday. Here inside the conference hall where I'm standing now, it's late at night, most people have already left, but here it's been this combination of high-end diplomatic meetings and a sort of trade show conference feel to everything. The whole goal, as we've discussed, is about getting world leaders to commit to reduce their greenhouse gas emissions so that the planet doesn't warm to a dangerous degree. Complicating all of that is a Washington Post investigation that dropped this morning that indicated that many nations around the world have been grossly overstating how much emissions reductions they've been doing. They've been using all sorts of complicated data, and the Washington Post breaks all that down. And so the issue is, if this whole conference is about getting people to put down very specifically how much they will reduce their emissions, if, as the Post reports, that a lot of this is based on dubious data, that really complicates matters here.
So, William, when it comes to galvanizing nations, we know former President Obama was there, spoke to the conference today, urging countries to step up. Tell us, how was his message received?
That's right. The former president's speech initially got a something of a standing ovation here in the hall. And he got forward and he said there have been real roadblocks to progress. He acknowledged that there is still an enormous amount to do. But he said this COP has already had some real substantial progress. That said, we talked to some activists who came into the conference hall today who argued and specifically mentioned President Obama, that he and other Western leaders are paying lip service to action instead of really taking concrete steps. I talked with one young activist from South Africa. Her name is Raisa Noor Mohammed. Here's what she had to say.
We're in the climate crisis right now. We're in the position we're in because of empty promises, because they prioritize themselves and their economies over the planet and the people. They've always been putting profit over people, and why would this be any different?
The former president took on these criticisms head on. He acknowledged that there had been, as he called them, imperfect compromises, and that all the past victories were not full victories. But that said, he said to these activists very directly, I want you to stay angry, I want you to stay frustrated, but turn those emotions into action, keep pushing us, world leaders, to do better. And so far, they seem to be heeding his wishes.
Interesting that the former president is engaged in this. And William, you're gonna be there for the rest of the week and will be reporting for us. Thank you very much.
You're welcome, Judy.